around in 1985, 1986, you simply could not escape the band Mr. Mister. Few acts burned hotter. Back-to-back number ones, including this song, Kyrie, number one album, Grammy nominations, constantly on MTV. What I bet you didn't know is that the lead singer, Richard Page, he grew up here in Phoenix, and far from disappearing over the last 30 years, Richard Page has had a remarkable career. When you see this, what comes to mind, that period in your life?
Man, I looked a lot better then.
Richard Page was 32 years old when he reached the pinnacle of pop music.
Were you having fun or was it?
Oh, I was having fun. Okay.
Page's wild musical ride began at Central High School, where he starred in several musicals.
For me, it was a great experience. I was a horrible student and really just literally begged the vice principal to graduate me, and he did because he knew that my interests were in music and that I had sort of excelled in that area.
And his classmates at Central voted him most likely to succeed.
The guy with the worst grades.
When he graduated in 1971, he was free to chase his dream.
So the day I graduated high school, 18, that week, we went to Hollywood.
Page, along with Sunny Slope grad, keyboardist Steve George, knocked around the LA music scene, eventually working with top flight acts like REO Speedwagon, Andy Gibb, Al Jarreau, and Kenny Loggins.
It really kind of opened a bunch of doors for us, but we never felt like the itch was fully scratched, because Steve and I really wanted to have our own band.
The bands Chicago and Toto even recruited Page to be their lead singer. He declined.
Struggled a little bit, and then we wrote Broken Wings, and you know, the thing just exploded. So take these broken wings and learn to fly again, learn to live so free. The song was so long, it was over 5 minutes, and people were telling us, it's too long. No program director, music director, any radio station will play it. It's way too long. So we tried all these edits and tried to take this part out, put that in, shorten this and that, and it didn't work. And so finally, I just looked at the engineer when we were editing, and I said, just write 4 minutes, 20 seconds on it. And nobody ever questioned.
Page and his cousin John Lang, also from Phoenix, had just pinned their first number one, and they were poised with a monster follow-up. Kyrie eleison, Greek for Lord have mercy. Lang wrote the lyric.
Because I always loved the sound of that Kyrie eleison. And when they'd sing it, and it would reverberate around in the church, and I said, man, come on, we can't do that.
Page worried Mr. Mister would be pegged as a Christian band. Lang insisted.
And he said, well, just try it. Just see what you can do with it. So we got into the studio and started singing, and it just fell together so perfectly.
Most listeners couldn't figure out what Page was singing.
You know, it wasn't about proselytizing or any of that stuff, and I was worried that that's what it would come across as being. But, you know, in retrospect, like I said, you know, people thought it was Kyrie Eleison. So.
Anything else that came out of that?
Kyrie Raisin?
Kyrie Raisin.
Suddenly, Page was on top of the music world, and he never saw it coming.
When you wrote Kyrie and Broken Wings, did you kind of have a sneaking suspicion?
None at all.
No.
No. I think I naively thought that it would last, you know, that it would just keep going, that we had everyone's attention now. It number one hits, the album was number one.
But the follow-up record 2 years later never reached those dizzying heights.
Sometimes it just goes your way, sometimes it doesn't. That's all I can say, you know. Don't take it too seriously. You know, I was pretty taken aback by it. I was pretty disappointed. But now that I'm older and I look at it, I view it more as a blessing.
And a lesson that fame can be a curse.
I've seen other people, you know, I've just tasted it enough to appreciate it. And then been able to go back and have a great relationship with my wife and a great family and a kind of a normal, healthy life. I've only met a few people who've managed to really navigate that and still have some equanimity and have some understanding and some humility. Now, Ringo being one of them.
Ringo Starr, drummer of the most famous rock and roll band of all time, the Beatles, fueled Page's musical passion. Fitting that he's now a member of Ringo's All-Star Band.
If you'd told me when I was trying to learn Day Tripper on guitar that I would be playing with the drummer of this band, you know, I would have thought you were crazy.
And in concert, Page's songs, Kyrie and Broken Wings, get some of the best reaction, even after 30 years.
When you start the intro to either song, the recognition is undeniable, and people just go crazy. It's a part of their existence. I'm so overwhelmed by the appreciation that people have of it.
Now, after the success of Mr. Mister, Page played or wrote with so many huge acts, I can't even name them all. Madonna, Michael Jackson, Andre Bocelli, Celine Dion, Donna Summer, Hall & Oates. It goes on and on. Where did he get his musical talent? Well, his mother, Joyce, was assistant director of the Phoenix Boys Choir for years, and his father, the music director at a local church. Music is in his blood. Thanks to Richard Page. Great time getting to catch up. To see my entire interview with Richard Page, you can go to my Facebook page, John Hook, Fox 10, Phoenix.